Christian traditions, they actually baptize the baby naked in cold water. And that's a little bit too severe. We have all been baptized ourselves. I know that in my case, I was baptized a really long time ago. Your son suggested that maybe 100 years old. He's a wiser man. So I'm going to sprinkle you now with water to remind you of your baptismal vows. So maybe as they see the hope of eternal life shine on their children, may he bless the mother of this child. She now thanks God for the gift of her child. May she be one with him, thanking him forever in heaven, in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. God is the giver of all life and divine. May he bless the father of this child. With his wife, he will be the first teacher of his child in the ways of faith. May he also be the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and do. In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And then finally, for all present, by God's gift through water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn to everlasting life. In his goodness, may he continue to pour out his blessings upon all present who are his sons and daughters. May he make you always, wherever you may be, faithful members of his holy people. May he send his peace upon all who are gathered here. In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And my friends, may the Lord be with you all and with your spirit. May Almighty God continue to bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The celebration is complete. Put a round of applause for Cian. We need photographers now. We gotta get pictures. Lots of pictures. Pictures. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. On this very special day, the church has three very special blessings. And I'm going to want you to go over and stand by your godchild. Okay, now over and stand by your godchild, all of you. This candle is the Easter candle. It's blessed every Easter. Celebrating Christ's resurrection, it symbolizes Christ's presence in the church. And we pass that light on to Cian. So Cian received the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept from the bridegroom. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. He is to walk always as a child of the light. May he keep the flame of faith alive in his heart. And when the Lord comes again, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. Our final symbol of baptism is what is called the ephphata rite, or be open. This is the word that Jesus used on the man who was blind and couldn't speak, deaf, blind, and dumb, couldn't speak here or anything. Jesus basically touches his eyes, his ears, and his mouth and opens them up. And we're going to do the same thing to him. So the Lord Jesus made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. He soon touch your ears. So it's an oil that recalls in a particular way the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, we know, is present, but you can't really see or feel it. This has a wonderful reminds us that just because we can't see something doesn't mean it isn't there.